It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door.
Listen, Natasha.
What's up,
it's the winter time. It's cold, okay?
I haven't seen you,
what, 8 months ago?
Yeah.
I haven't seen you? You know, I mean, you're not easy to catch. I can catch the president quicker than I can catch you. How you doing, by the way?
I'm right, besides being cold.
How's Virginia?
Virginia's all right, warm, okay. Country, born. Yeah.
How's your husband?
He good, he's a husband. It's all right.
Listen, you know, Christmas is like around the corner, a few weeks away.
Yeah.
And I was thinking about this, and I know it's kind of hard, you know, for us as a family, but I wanted to get together this Christmas holiday.
Okay, so I gotta bring my razor blade in my mouth. I'm only coming for a plate, I'm not coming. To ship off to Virginia because I'm
come
not
on,
coming.
Come on, Natasha, on the for real. Why are you gonna be like that?
Can you FedEx the plate of food?
Why can't you come?
You can't even put your pocketbook down when you go in the crib.
Not like that
family steals. Oh, it's not like that no more.
Don't worry about it.
Only if security's at the door and there's a dress code, no Tim's, no do-rags.
Listen.
Everybody has a belt on.
Natasha, okay. Don't do that, seriously.
On that note.
Don't do that, Natasha. I'm serious. That's
on that note. Don't do what? I'm not doing nothing.
Come to the family door. Why are you not gonna come? See, this is the problem with family, okay? We hurt each other, and we hold grudges and unforgiveness for years. And I'm like, listen, you gotta get past that. I'll admit, you know what I'm saying? Deborah, she hurt me a couple of times. Certain things she didn't say, but I forgave
not
her.
Not just once.
I forgave her. I let it go.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
That's up
like
to
when
you.
She borrowed a car from me that time. You know what I'm saying? I let her borrow the car. Remember that time I let her borrow the car to drive to Florida
she
with
borrowed
the kids?
Your car. She ain't
borrowed
yeah,
she
my
borrowed
car.
My car. Uh-huh. And I told her, listen, make sure, you know, after your vacation, you come back because I'm going to need it because I was on vacation too.
Right. And she left you with a boot on your car and an empty gas tank. So.
Yeah, but I forgave her. And I had to pay
that's
for
up
it.
To
I admit. You know, I had to pay for it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you paid
on
for it.
On top of that, she crashed the car too. But I forgave her. I don't hold it against her. So why can't you forget?
I'm going to go to Costco and get that cheesecake variety sampler. Because I don't really like y'all like that.
Just show up to the film. Okay? December 25th.
Maybe.
Okay? Just show up. On the for real. Come on, do that for me.
Maybe.
All right, sis?
If mom makes ribs, maybe.
Do that for me, all right?
If mom makes ribs, maybe.
All right, look.
Factory closed,
I'm sorry,
darling.
I'm sorry. Forgive me for asking. I'm sorry. Okay. Whatever that is.
Yeah. Next.
You know. You know, whatever it is.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
So yeah.
Leave it.
My business is my life.
Water under the bridge.
My business.
Speaking of business, how is your magazine company?
Doing great.
Yeah. What's the name of the
Rejuvenate.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, speaking of Rejuvenate, I just finished talking with Tasha. Look out.
The drama diva.
Yeah, because you know how that goes. I told her about the reunion.
Oh my God.
And she's like, is wasn't it going to be there? I was like, well, yeah. She was like, I'm like, look, Natasha, come on now. That's your sister.
Yeah.
You gotta let go.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna say it like this. Just let go.
Yeah.
Let it go.
I mean, how long has it been? She's married, you know,
everything.
She ain't even with him anymore.
But you know what she upset with? The fact that her sister had did that.
Yeah.
You know, we all know she was like that.
People make mistakes.
Yeah, but she's grown up now, even though they had a kid, you know, but she's no longer with him.
She's getting money now too, right?
Yeah, she is.
Yeah.
She's got three kids. But she had one kid by her.
Yeah.
Two kids by her, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know.
Bow is yourself about that one.
Yeah. But, you know, her and her stuff separate.
Oh.
Not Natasha, the other one.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know.
Yeah, they separate for right now. I don't know what's going on with them. I have no idea. I didn't, you know.
Well, maybe that fight time she ain't coming back. She ain't trying to have a replay over them.
But I told her, but all jokes aside, I told her, listen. We gotta get together for family. We can't be living like that. Okay? We're the Joneses.
Yeah.
And everybody try to keep up with us.
Yeah.
Okay?
Which is a law,
John. But here's the thing. Everybody try to keep up with the Joneses, but the Joneses ain't trying to keep up with each other.
What's wrong with
you? What's going on? I don't know. I have no idea. But you know what? I'm hoping and praying that Natasha has a heart. So you know what? This is family. And what we went through was bigger. It's what we went through is smaller than family. So let's just move on. But yeah. So, that's that. I'm not going to spoil nothing. So.
Well, with that, I'm throwing my penny in there. We're going to make that happen.
Okay. Okay. Well, I'm not throwing nothing.
I threw it for us all.
Oh, for us all. Okay, good.
Yeah.
Because I ain't throwing nothing. The cost of living in New York is too high for me to be throwing money into some water that some drug addict go get at midnight. But look, December 25th.
Okay. At Auntie.
We're going to start like 5 or 6 o'clock. But I'm going to get there early to try to set up and hook up everything. Make everything look real nice.
I'll bring my green.
Oh, you got to bring your green.
Absolutely.
Oh,
my green.
And your sweet potato pie.
Okay. One for now, one for later.
I'll bring 4.
Why?
I got to get 3. You know, look at me.
I tell you what, I'm tucking on the side.
Tucking on the side.
There you go.
Oh, by the way, I heard you just got in your car. What are you telling me? What kind?
Maserati, baby.
What?
The G-Wing. The new one.
Get out.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You got to let me test drive the car.
Well, I tell you what, I'll come pick you up.
Okay, all right.
And then we'll drive down.
Okay, all right, no problem. I'll do that. Let me get back to you on that because...
That'll be our excuse to leave.
Okay.
I got to take him home.
Now, because I'm trying to be the mediator to the whole family.
Right.
Because when Natasha and Sis come together, you know, I don't want to invent the holy snow Mike Tyson. She's working on her.
Yeah, no, I don't want that.
You know what I'm saying? You know how they get. You know, because Natasha's like... Eat it like the devil, still at her sister.
No love in hip hop.
Exactly. No love in hip hop, you know, or reggae.
Yeah.
And her sister's like, oh well, hey, I do what I have to do.
Exactly.
She ain't saying it, but it's like she's not thinking about it.
Yeah.
So hopefully everything's gonna go well.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's gonna be a fun, filled family gathering. Okay.
Okay.
Everybody will come together as family.
Okay.
We'll sit down. We're gonna talk. Your community, okay? Maybe bring your friends or whatever. But I know you're going to come. I know you're going
to
come.
But I want her to meet, you know, Auntie and everybody else.
Exactly.
If the crazy drama divas do their thing, we'll be exit stage left.
Exactly. So I'm going to be up in there trying to make sure everybody is okay. I know I joke around a lot, but I got to call you referee between you know who.
Hopefully not.
And I'm like...
The Lord willing.
Yeah, hopefully not.
Hopefully in the season of love, the spirit will come upon me.
Well, this is a season of love. But love is with a teeny bit of hate sometimes.
There's a thin line between love and hate.
Yeah, there's a thin line between the Joneses and not getting along with the Joneses. So, you know, we're going to see. Okay, so we're going to see. So listen, because... Hey, Mom, how you doing?
I'm doing good. How are you, David?
How's school?
School's pretty good. I'm still trying to figure out if I'm going to major in art and drawing and graphic novels or if I'm going to do something else. So, It's kind of up in the air.
So what are you planning on doing for the holiday, for Christmas? You going back home to Milwaukee to see your family?
Oh, I was thinking of, I don't know, I have a friend, she's an international student. She's she's based in Paris. So I was thinking maybe we might go out there and hang out, you know, and compare cities, you know, and see if New York and Paris are as great as they claim or as rude as they claim. So I'll have to see.
Well, with me, I'm getting together with my family. Again, after 5 years from the last time we got together on Christmas, we all coming back together again. So it's gonna be Christmas at the Joneses. One more time.
Oh man, I can't complain. Oh man.
Still doing my thing as usual.
I hear you.
No complaints.
That's appropriate. Okay. Well, you know, Grants. Yeah. It's that time of year again.
Oh yes.
Christmas come around, yeah. And you know, then it's gonna be New Year's. Everything gonna start all over again.
Right.
And so, but I've been talking to some of the relatives.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. And we're going to, after 5 years of the last one we had,
right,
we're finally coming together and going to have another Christmas at the house.
Okay.
You remember how the last one was?
Right, right.
Turned out pretty good. Everything went well.
But you know, the two sisters, you know,
oh,
my granddaughters is something else.
Grant, I'm going to tell you, it's the hardest to get them two together.
Oh.
I mean, I spoke with Natasha.
Yes.
And Natasha's like, no, I ain't forgiving her. She there. She did what she did was wrong. I said, listen, we're sisters. We're family.
Family, yeah. Family.
Okay? You got to let that go.
Let it go. They're sisters.
And I mean, and she just so tight with it. I mean, I understand, you know, what sis did to her was wrong.
Yes.
That's understandable.
Understand.
Like I told her, look, she did me wrong too. Remember right. That day with the car?
Right.
You know, but I let that. It go. I was upset. I mean, I held grudges for her by like 2 weeks to a month.
Right.
Then I realized, you know, that's blood.
Blood,
that's
yes.
Family.
Gotta let it go.
Gotta let it go. And this is a time of caring and sharing.
Yes.
You know?
Gotta get together.
Exactly. So, you know, I was speaking to her about that. She was just being hard-headed. You know, Natasha has been like
don't
that for
tell
the
me.
Longest.
Oh, boy. I try to talk to her. Oh, it's hard to get over to her.
I mean,
once you get you on her bad side, you on her bad side.
Yeah, that's how she is. And she was like flipping out. You know, I'm like, come on, sis. She was, we met over there by Macy's and 34th Street in Manhattan. And she would say, listen, you gonna give me a Macy's coupon? Because like, she didn't want to talk about this.
Right.
You know, and I'm like, listen, we try.
Into that.
Yeah, all into that, you know, and this and with that attitude.
I know.
You know, so I'm like, oh my good, I understand. So I'm hoping and praying when we get together, definitely she gonna be there.
Yes.
And there'll be no quarrelsome. You know, there'll be no
bury the hatchet.
Exactly. I don't need none. I'm not trying to be a referee. I mean, I'm talking
right.
to everybody.
Right.
You know, I spoke to uncle and auntie about it and stuff. We're going to have it back at their place.
Right.
And you know, auntie got a new, what's in there, a new house.
Oh, well, we got to go and see how that
is. Yeah, she got a new house. I don't know if we're going to have it at the same place or we're going to have the new place, but she got a new house.
Oh, man.
Okay, so
see
I told her about it. I told them about it. And I said, listen, we all going to come together, okay? Mm-hmm. I mean, all the other cousins got some more they got to meet and talk to. So, you know, I definitely want you to come there.
Oh, yeah, I'll be there.
You know, maybe me and you can do the pie eating contest again.
All right. now you're trying to make me hate.
I don't need no more pie, but hey, I make an exception for Christmas.
Trying to make me, I'm going to outdo you now, you know that.
Yeah, you did me last time. You did me last time, but I got you on the donuts.
Oh,
you
yes, know. You did. Oh, wow. He a donut eater.
Yeah, I'm a donut eater. Yeah, but the next...
I had to drop my head.
Yeah, but later that night, I couldn't sleep. I had diarrhea for like 3 hours.
Oh, my goodness.
Hey, look, donuts and drinking hot chocolate.
Oh, yeah.
It'll do something to you. You know, but I say, no more. Yeah, so when we're going to get together, we're going to have a whole lot of food. You know, a whole lot of everything coming in and stuff like that. And, you know, we just going to do our thing, you know. Mm-hmm. You know, you can bring your little girlfriend.
Well, you know I'm trying.
Right now, you know what? Forget about it, Grant. I'm calling you uncle. Forget about it, Grant. You know, I know you. We're just going to be family, okay?
All right.
Family oriented, okay?
Okay, well,
this ain't a nightclub. It's not a party, okay? I know you, Grant. It's not a party. But yeah, we're going to get together and stuff. And, you know, when we get there, you know, I may want you to talk to Natasha. No?
I will.
Natasha mainly, because Natasha, yes. You know.
She's the hardest one to get it through her head, man. Once you get on her bad side, that's it.
You know, Grandpa, I realized something. Sometimes family can be, if you don't have God in your life,
it will be hard on you. You gotta have God in your life.
If you don't, it seems like family should be the main one that you have.
Yes.
You know, supposed to be God first and family second.
That's right.
Okay, but if you don't have God, then your family should always be there. Mm-hmm. But sometimes family. I got to be real, Uncle. Excuse me, Grandpa. You kind of look like, you know, Uncle. What's
the young one.
Yeah, yeah. The one who passed a long time ago. Mm-hmm. But I got to be real, Gramps. Sometimes family can be your worst enemy.
Yeah.
You know that. But then again, you got to realize this. You got to love your enemy. Yeah. That's not your enemy, it's your family. But sometimes those who's close to you can hurt you the most.
Oh, yes, they can catch you off guard because
you know
you're not paying them any mind, and they
exactly, and they'll get you
and
get you good.
I mean, really, you know, get you good.
So I'm hoping, and I pray, and I believe that everything's gonna be good. Everything's gonna come out good. Okay, I mean, this is Christian with the Joneses. Everybody talk about us all the time.
All the time.
Keeping up with the Joneses. Okay.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna try to do it right.
Time. But sometimes the Joneses can't keep up with themselves.
That's right.
Now, all of us, some of us, all the time. So I'm hoping, I'm praying that all gonna be well. Cause it's like, you know, Natasha, she's just like a Mike Tyson, wanna fight somebody.
Yeah, she wanna fight.
She's doing good. She's in Virginia, you know, right. And stuff. She working, and okay. She has a husband, you know. He has his own trucking business and stuff like that. You never met him yet, right?
No.
No, matter of fact, you couldn't even make it. You couldn't make it to the wedding.
No.
I think you was taking care of some business and everything and stuff, and you know.
Yes,
and she was like, he could have came and all that stuff. I said, well, you know, what she ain't saying that day, you know, when I met with her. But she said it at the wedding. What's wrong? He could have got to, you know, he's a Vietnam veteran, you know, and he had to go out of town
to take care of that business.
You know, he would have came.
Of course.
You know, but, you know, he got stuck out there. So,
yes.
And he sent y'all a check, you know, $10,000 and everything, you know.
Something to keep going, you know.
You know, exactly.
A new person in the family.
Exactly. So, we're going to come out there, and I figured, you know, you were talking, because, you know, you got the, like, I would say the greatest wisdom of everybody, meaning that you've been around the longest, you're the oldest,
yes.
You've been to 2 world wars,
oh, yes.
You've been to college, you got your 2 master degrees, okay, in psychology, you know,
yes,
you're a retired veteran, you know.
I work on their brain.
Yeah, you was also a cop, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you was a cop for a couple of years, then became a fez, and then you got out of that. And now you just enjoying.
Dangerous.
Well, we ain't gonna go into that, okay? We ain't gonna go into that when you was all over in London and all that other stuff,
everywhere.
And you know, Albuquerque and all that. We ain't gonna go into that.
World.
And people probably still looking for you, but
right. They
probably dead by now. That's way back in the '70s, '80s. Okay.
I'm glad.
Well, thank good God had his hand on you. Okay. So you okay now?
I'm okay.
Okay, you still look good, man. You still look good. You still look real good.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? Got that Forrest Whitaker look for you. but you good. But yeah, Grant. Yeah, we're gonna do it. Let's pray for Natasha.
Oh yes,
okay.
I'll pray for her.
We're gonna come out there.
She'll hurt up.
Yeah, we're gonna come out there and, you know, just pray for her.
I will.
And what's her name, sis? What's her name? Her kids are big now.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, Trina.
I want to see them.
Her kids are big. They grown up now.
Oh, man.
I mean, they said they were babies. They grown up.
Oh,
okay.
Man.
You know, everybody be trying to say, you know, people are talking like, look, man, David, how in the world you get in contact with Grandpa? Everybody, it's so hard to contact. You like, you don't answer your phone. Say, I know how to get to him. I go to the house.
I say,
you know how Grandpa is. You know, he's been through 7 marriages, 7 divorces.
Right.
He got like 50 women. or under the age of 50.
Busy man.
Under the age of 50, older than 25.
That's right.
Beyonce looking type.
That's right.
You don't have to go to Hawaii. Hawaii comes to the house.
The house.
You know how grass is. But yeah, we're going to have that, okay?
Okay.
I just want to let you know that December 25th,
okay.
You know, I'm going to have it at auntie's house. I'm going to say, I know you do the computer, yes. Right? All right, I'm going to send you an email and let you know where, okay?
Okay, fine.
So we're going to do that, okay? Mm-hmm. So listen, let me get up out of here. Mm-hmm. You know, it's very warm up here because it's mad cold outside.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm going to get up out of here, you know, try to get some sleep and get ready. It's going to start like about 4 or 5 o'clock.
Okay, I'll be there.
I'm going to be there early. I'm going to try to get there like about 2-ish.
Okay,
all right,
I'll come by 2.
Yeah, come by 2, okay?
Right.
I'll make sure we have like a snack.
Oh,
I gotta try. I gotta give you this new thing I heard about.
What's
from Atlanta?
No, man. What is it?
Texas. It's called shoe fly pie.
What's that?
You ever heard of shoe fly pie?
No.
Oh, Grant, forget about
it. What is this shoe fly pie?
It tastes good. It tastes like pecan pie. A little bit.
Oh, okay.
I know your favorite is apple and cranberry, but yeah, I'm gonna let you try this pecan with the shoe fly pie. I'm gonna try to get what's her name to bring it.
I'll try to get our other cousin to bring it.
Yeah. You still do your peanut butter and ice cream?
Of course. That's my thing.
You got me doing that. You know, one day sister's like, what you eating? Peanut butter and ice cream? So, yeah, you know, yes. Grandpa got me doing this. Tastes kind of good.
That's good.
You know, you get calcium from milk and you get the protein from peanut butter. Right. All it is smushed up peanuts into cream, peanut butter ice cream.
Good.
And she was like, you know, sister's like, you know, she was like, you know, yeah, but we black folk, only white people do that. I said, well, hey, that's why they live to be at least 50 years older than we.
That's right. Eating the good stuff.
Eating the good stuff. We eat all that Chinese food, all that crap.
That good
stuff. Diarrhea McDonald's crap.
Oh,
you know,
man.
Which I despise. I know you never ate that stuff. You see, you and Pop was like a home cooked meal person.
That's what I want now.
You was a home cooked meal person. Being that you're from North Carolina,
that's right.
You said a home cooked meal. You barely like eating out.
I don't like eating out.
Home cooked meal, home cooked grits and all that stuff.
Oh man. Cooked. Yum, yum, yummy.
Even the one of the ladies had to bring it over from their house.
That's
it's gotta
right.
be home cooked.
Home cooked. They know.
Yeah, but in this generation, we want everything fast. They want everything quick and fast.
Food. Fast food everywhere.
Everybody. Fast food, fatter.
They don't know, some of them don't even know how to cook. I'm like, you don't know how to cook? How do you survive? Oh, I go to the restaurant here every day.
A true story, let me go. It's funny though. A long time ago, I heard this lady in the church I was in, right? Mm-hmm. And she said that she's speaking to a friend of hers. Mm-hmm. And she said her friend was about to get married. Mm-hmm. And she said, you know, but one thing, her friend was a female, her friend's fiance don't know that she cooked. She don't cook. She said, I don't cook. She said, well, how you gonna like survive? So, she said, well, I don't cook, but he doesn't know that. So when we get married, we're going to order out every night. Oh, my goodness. Okay.
I'll see
you and Dr. Phil soon.
Yes. You will be and ask them, what can I do?
Oh, my goodness. Oh, she would have survived back in the 40s.
No.
That is insane. I mean,
everybody was cooking that, you know.
Everybody's cooking back then.
Everybody was cooking.
It's not like now. Today is a lot different. Today it's like, you know, I do my own thing. I do what I want to do.
Right.
The first thing a woman would say, ain't your mother going to cook your own food?
That's what they say.
You know?
Yes, they do. You got that right.
That's right. Go kick your own food. And I'm like, oh my goodness. I mean, thank goodness I'm still single for the time being.
I ain't rushing it.
I ain't rushing it yet. Mm-hmm. Okay, when the time for me to get married,
there's a difference.
I come and talk to you. That's the wisdom.
I will give you the wisdom too. You got a good one? Hold on tight
to it.
That's right, with all your might.
Don't see each other too much.
Yeah, give her room.
Give her room.
Give her room. This way they miss you a little bit, but you're not really gone. You'll be back, but just a little while in between to miss each other.
Exactly.
That make you... When you get together,
exactly.
Oh, baby.
And don't do what you did by mistake.
Definitely.
I think you told me a long time ago, you was one of your wives and you made a mistake and you said, you was in the bed and you called your wife, your ex-girlfriend's name.
Yeah.
That's not a nice thing.
Wait, no. Hey.
You know the bedroom was turned upside down after that.
I was like, yeah, Barry White music couldn't help you there, Grandpa.
Nothing. And you know, you're supposed to know their name, no matter what.
Your wife is Candy, you say Lorraine.
She said, what?
Who's Lorraine? That's it. All we knew was about it. But yeah, Grants, I'm about to get up out of here. I got to go take care of some business. So.
Alrighty.
So listen, yeah.
Glad
yeah,
to
definitely.
See you.
Glad
and
to
thank
see
you for the information. So I'll be at that.
No problem. Like I said, everybody says hard to get a grant. Get in contact with you. But I know. You're on the run. I'm surprised you're here now.
Yes, you
probably. You know what I'm saying? But I'm always like, you know, let me go check out Graham. Matter of fact, I'm not even going to call him. I'm just going to show up.
Yes.
Okay, and here you are. Because you're like, you about to go out now.
I'm getting ready.
Hey, do what you got to do, Graham.
You know how it is.
Hey, you're never too old to hang out.
Hey.
This is New York City.
When you really don't go, you start aging yourself.
I heard a wise man say once, matter of fact, I think from Quincy Jones, I'm not sure.
Mm-hmm.
I heard him say once, you know what? When you get to the age of 60, you really begin to start living.
Living.
And I heard somebody else say, yeah, that's true, because you know why? Why? By the time you get older, you done saw everything.
Everything.
And Grandpa, I know you saw everything. And things you ain't want to.
And some.
And not only that, you was a part of it. Most of it.
All of it. That's right. It was right there with it. In the middle of the action. Having a good time.
All right, Grant, let me get up out of here. All right. So I'm going to go, right? So let me go.
Be safe.
Okay, give you a hug.
All righty.
It's always good to see you.
All righty.
All right. Uh-huh. Love you, Grant. Okay.
Yo, what's up, man?
Chillin', man. How you doing, man?
Yo, I ain't seen you in a minute, man. How's everything?
Everything is cool, man. Everything is good, man. How's your daughter?
Yo, she's doing good. I ain't gonna complain, man. She's growing up, man. She's getting bigger now, so I'm trying to do my thing for her and shit. You know what I mean?
I hear you. Are you still going through the baby mama drug?
I'm gonna always have that. That's life, man. You know what I mean? I'm doing my thing. They out in Virginia still and all that, so, you know, her mom, she see me and shit. She wants to make sure I'm on my grind. I ain't on the streets no more. You know, she wanna make sure I'm doing my thing, so I gotta do it for the baby.
How the family, baby?
Family doing good. Matter of fact, I'm glad I ran into you, yo. Yo, I just left Grandpa, man.
How he doing?
He doing, you know, Grandpa, the big OG pimp. You know what that is, retired.
He's still pimping?
You know how it is,
that's,
you know what I'm saying?
Crazy, man.
You know, I mean, he's cooling out, you know, because he retired and stuff like that and stuff and everything. And World War II and all that kind of, you know, messed him up a bit. He's just relaxing. But, you know, the man still got like 50 women all around.
He don't want to pass none to me, man. That's crazy, man. Grandpa be doing this thing. I ain't mad at him.
Yeah, I'm like, look, y'all going with that. But anyway, listen. I'm glad I ran into you. Yo, we're going to have another family gathering for Christmas.
A what?
Family gathering for Christmas.
I don't know what that means, man. Because the last time we had one of those, they wowed out.
Come on, man. That was like five years ago.
Why do you put yourself in situations like that? You know how the family is when we get together, man. They be wilding lately ever since that shit happened, man. A what? I didn't listen. You talking about the whole family?
The whole family, the Black Brady Bunch.
You know the last time we did that, what happened, right?
Come on, man, you got a good off that, man.
You remember or not?
Yeah, I remember.
Because you acting like you don't remember what happened the last time.
But look, that was like, 5 years ago, the last time we got together? So look, this is going to be different now.
Yeah, right. Yeah, you know we black people, hey, you know.
The only thing is Natasha and Trina.
Right.
Them two. That's what
I'm saying. Those are two I'm talking about. You remember what happened with them, right?
Yeah, I remember, man, but it's going to be out. Don't worry, man. I don't worry about it. I mean, I spoke to Natasha,
okay.
And I admit, she's on some ego gangster trip, like, if I come and bring a razor blade and send me a plate, I don't even like y'all like that. And I'm like, listen, get off of that.
You want to have a family gathering.
Yeah, man, I mean, it's been like 5 years.
I just wanted to be popping, but listen.
Come on, man. Plus, what's her name? Just got a new house. Auntie, she got another house.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she still got the old house we was at before,
right.
But, you know, she got this one as well. And I don't know if she's going to sell that one, or I'll totally give it to the family.
Right. I need that other one. No, that was nice.
That thing's worth like $2 million.
You got another one already?
Yeah, I think the nuts in the new one she played like about $1 million or a little bit more, $3 million.
Killing
like
my head. Y'all need that other crib, man. Like I was plotting on that for a minute. You know, Auntie was fretting on the kid, but now she got a new joint. I gotta hit her up, man.
Yeah, you gotta let her know. Let her know. Just, you know, she'll be there definitely. Well, listen, I want us to get together. You know what I'm saying? It's been like 5 years, bro. Five,
every time,
Tony.
I hear about you and the family, I don't know, man. Listen, Christmas too, plus I got the new job and all that. You know, I don't know if I can really make it on Christmas Day. It's interesting running into you, but as far as Christmas go, man, I might have to work that day, bro.
Another job, Tony?
Yeah, I got to make that money, baby. It's hard. Man, bro. You live in New York City, man.
I know, rent going out, everything going out. I understand. Crazy baby mama dramas, all
that
stuff.
Yeah, I still got that. That ain't going to go nowhere. As long as my baby alive, I'm going to always have issues with her. Yeah.
All right, well, how about her? Did you and her still?
I don't fuck with her like that.
Okay, all right.
We talk, we called you, but when she get on her bullshit,
yeah.
I got cut off the phone. I don't got time for that, man. I'm trying to do my thing.
She's in Virginia,
yeah,
right?
Luckily, she ain't in the fucking hood, and I have to deal with it every day. It's just a phone call.
I don't know. Yeah, no.
You know, I could just be like, yo, bye.
Look, I remember you back in the days, Tone. I remember how you was, you know, you running around with your cats.
Right.
You could have just easy, clack, clack, clack.
Nah, I wouldn't do that, too, because he's my baby mom.
I know.
Wasn't for the baby.
Yeah, wasn't for the baby.
You feel me?
Look. As long as you know you do what you gotta do, be a good father to your child.
Oh, yeah,
and stuff
of course,
like that,
man. You don't gotta do that.
Yeah,
nah,
definitely.
We do.
And I definitely wanna see her again.
Okay.
So you gotta come.
Well, she coming there for the holidays, but I don't know if I can make Christmas, man. Like, I ain't going front. I might have to work day. I just got the new gig, bro.
So you got like 50 jobs in a week. What's up, man?
I gotta get that money. Listen to me. I don't know how you feel about it, but I gotta get that money.
No, I feel you. I feel you.
I go where the money at.
I know. I feel you. So this
new gig, I'm like, I don't know if they're gonna let me off for Christmas, man.
That's how the family is. You know, we're about getting that dough, getting that cash, what we gotta do.
Right.
You know, preaching God, going to church, making money. That's what we do. But I feel you gotta do what you gotta do. I mean, because it's been 5 years since the last time we had one.
Right. And the last time we had one,
it was at the Black Animal House. You know what I'm saying? It was wild up, and it was like Smurfs against Gargamel.
Right.
You know?
This is what I'm gonna do, man. Let me get your number, bro. Let me hit you up.
Yeah, I got another phone, man.
Oh, you talking about me and Jaws, man. Every time I get a new job, you get a new phone, bro.
Yeah, I got to, man.
What's the number, man?
It's 646. I'm gonna take it too loud. Like 646. 555-5001.
Hey, Tom, I met you. I definitely good to run into you,
Tom,
fam.
You call me Tom. My name is Dave. Your name is Tom.
Okay, I got out of work when I'm still tired.
Every time I see you, I know you tired or you hot.
Nah. So, I don't smoke no more, man.
You stop.
Yeah, I get the drug test with the jobs and all that. You know, like I said, I just got out of
brother,
work, man.
I'm glad, man. I'm glad for you, man. That's a good thing.
We trying.
That's a sign of turning around, man.
Yeah. I'm getting older now, man. I can't do the same shit I was doing when I was younger. You know, I'm maturing now and shit.
What you like, 29, 30?
Come on, I'm 30, baby. Come on, man. I know it's been a while, but you don't even know how old the cuzzo is, man.
Yeah, you was like, last time I saw you, was like, what, 19 or something like that?
Nah, you saw me 5 years ago for the party.
Oh, my bad.
See, that's how crazy it was. You don't even remember the kids.
You so tired. I'm looking to your eyes. I'm falling into a trench. I'm getting tired.
Good to see you, man.
Yeah, man.
What's up,
I gotta get up out of here, man. But I'm glad to see you. But try to make it. You can, man.
I'll give you a call, man.
Yeah, call me. Definitely, man. Call me, man.
All right, bro.
We'll talk.
Good to see you, man.
See you.
Busy.
Listen, I'm glad I ran into you. By the way, how's everything going with you?
Chill for now. You see, I was shopping and stuff. I had to take a break.
Yeah.
With
your Gucci glasses, whatever those are.
Georgie Gabbani.
How much you pay? Like $500? $1,000? Okay.
Well, you know I'm high maintenance.
Huh?
You know I'm high maintenance.
I know. It runs with the family. We all high maintenance. We spend on the holidays. Then we broke the day after.
until the next week.
When that broke, but you know, we don't have none. We still got stuff in the bank account.
Right.
How you doing, by the way?
Good. How you been?
I've been real good. Listen, I'm so happy I ran into you. In fact, I was thinking about you on my way coming here.
Okay.
So it's kind of coincidence how I was thinking about you.
Goodbye,
and then I ran into you. Listen, check this out. I'm planning on getting us back together. Another Christmas gathering at the family.
Excuse me?
Come on now.
Excuse me?
Come on now, Quilla.
Excuse me?
Come on now, Quilla. Why you gotta lie? I just left Cousin Tony. He was acting the same way.
Well, is there any questions why? Think about it.
Listen. I understand how you feel about the two sisters, Natasha and Trina. I understand. But don't worry. I'm a referee then, okay?
Dysfunctional and toxic.
Look. It ain't gonna be like that. It's been since the last time we got together, we were like 5 years ago, remember? 5 years.
Turn up and said it'd be another 5 years.
Come on now. Don't act like that. Listen.
Why? They act like that.
We ain't gotta be like
they
them.
I don't want to be like no ghetto acting folk. They come in the house, they fight, they cussing, they got their drugs.
Well, look,
ain't got that.
It ain't gonna be like that this time, okay? I'm gonna be in the midst of this one. Okay, I'm gonna be in the middle. I'm gonna referee if I have to, okay? So everything's gonna be different this time.
But you shouldn't have to referee at
all. I know, but you know, I'm trying to bring the family together. This is Christmas, okay?
Well, without them, I could do this.
Without them, you could do this. No, with them, you could do this, okay? Listen, do it for me, cuz. Come on now. Coincidence how I was thinking about you,
Goodbye,
and then I ran
buddy.
Into you. Listen, check this out. I'm planning on
the deal going down. If I come in at the one time that they show up, I'm boogieing. I'm gonna bounce, okay? I'm bouncing. Me and mine are bouncing.
Okay, back. No problem.
I don't have time to be bothered with that trash. Okay?
I know this is Christmas, okay?
I don't care, but you're not gonna sweat me out on Christmas.
Okay, I tell you what, okay? Deal. Alright? Don't worry about it. It ain't gonna be that. You're gonna enjoy it, okay? Bring your famous collard greens. Get there like about 4 o'clock, 5 if you can, you know. I don't know. You got to work that day?
I don't know what I have to do.
Okay, how your business going? Your shoe business online?
Everything is going fantastic. It was fantastic. So you mentioned about who coming out here.
Oh, my goodness.
All the negativity.
You're acting like we're the family from hell. We're not.
I didn't say y'all. It's two. Just
yeah,
two
I know what you're talking about. I know what you mean.
Everybody. I know Tony said that, too.
Yeah, Tony got his issues. He got another job, by the way.
Oh, good for him.
Yeah, he's still, you know, going to go see his daughter, Virginia. He still got the baby mama drama going on. But he's doing it. He's not in the streets no more like he used to be.
Well, that's
he's
good.
Cool. He's pulling out.
That's
you
good.
Know, I know you had to bail him out a couple of times financially back in the day.
Yeah, but Tony's cool with me, though.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
He's cool with me, unlike some people I know.
So how you doing, Trina?
I'm good.
That's good. How's everything?
Like I said, everything's good. Why did you come over here so quickly? I know you got something up your sleeve. So don't try to play games with your sister.
Well, I just wanted to come see how you was doing.
Wanted to come see how you were doing. Sure. Like I said, I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm good. Okay. The real reason why I came, well, after 5 years, we're having another family Christmas gathering at Auntie's.
Here we go.
Come on. I know what you're going to say, okay? But it's going to be okay. It's going to be all right.
I don't want to deal with the drama.
I spoke to your sister, Natasha, already, okay? You're not the problem anymore. Well, according to her, you are. And I try to tell her, listen, let's just get past that. We're family, you know? You got to forgive and forget. This is a Christmas holiday, okay? It's called keeping up with the Joneses, all right?
Oh, yeah,
not keeping away. Not keep away from us, okay? It's bad enough we got enough drama from other people because of our last name and how popular we are, but we don't need to have drama with our, you know, with each other. So I want you to come out, okay? In fact, Natasha says she may not even come if you're going to
be. Oh, that'd be nice.
Come on, listen. I understand what was done in the past was the past, like I said. you made a mistake, okay?
Yeah, my mistake.
You made a mistake. At that time, it may not have seemed a mistake, but you made a mistake, okay? God, excuse me, your house is real heated. But listen, I want you to put that behind, okay? Don't worry. If I have to, I will be in the middle to referee. Okay? I don't want you to get wild and crazy and stuff like that, okay? I want everything to go peaceful.
Wild and crazy kid.
All right? And plus, Auntie just got a new house.
Different.
You know? Now, yeah, you ain't got to say it like that. Come on now. She's not the enemy. But anyway, listen, I just thought I'd let you know that because I don't know if we're going to be filming in her new house she got or the house we had before. I'm not sure. Now, I've been trying to get everybody together. I've been talking to everybody and stuff. And every time I talk to every individual, I just left on Cousin Tony. You know him, right? Mm-hmm. You know, he just got a new job, so he may not come. He don't know, and he had baby
mama. Okay, so
drama.
Nobody's going, so why do I have to come?
No. Everybody's coming. I'm trying to be like the mediator to y'all. Come on now.
Okay.
I mean, what's it going to take another 5 more years for us to come together as a family?
I don't care if it takes another 20.
It shouldn't be like that. See, this is the thing about family. It's like we could be at each other next. That's why you got these old crazy reality shows. You know, they friends be acting stupid and crazy. That's how family is, and we shouldn't be like that. We're supposed to be loving. And plus, it's Christmas. Come on now. Do you think your son would like to see that?
No, that's why I want to keep him away from it. Thank you. Holla.
Come on now. We're supposed to come together and show love. This is a time of sharing and caring. Okay? Caring and sharing.
I'll think about
okay?
it.
Okay? Come on now. Come on. I'll think about it. Come on, Trina. Look. Like I said, you're not the guilty one. Okay?
Although, 10 minutes ago, I was.
Now, according to her, but you're not the guilty. You just made a bad move. You made a wrong decision. That was back then. I don't hold you against it. I'll admit to you.
You weren't even there. You just know half of the story.
I admit to you. Remember that time I even told Natasha this about the time that you hold the car and what happened with the car?
Yeah.
You remember? Yeah. See, I forgive you. I don't hold nothing against you. If I was holding something against you, I'd be like, you know what? You're right, Natasha. Forgive her. Because you know what she did? She did this to me with the car and all that. But I said, no, I understand. You got to forgive and forget. I mean, come on now.
I don't know why y'all keep on bringing stuff back.
But you acting like you don't want to go. Your attitude is like...
Because I'd rather just stay away from the drama, keep me and my family just not subjected to all the BSS.
You see, you say you forgive and you forgot. If you really forgive, right? Like I was telling her, Natasha, you really forgive? You'll be like, okay, sure, come on, let's go on. You won't be like, I don't know. Because you're telling me one thing, but I can, you know, I can read minds. Because your mental, it shows out in your natural. So what that means is that you say one thing, but what's inside you is going to mean a whole demeanor.
So why should I come if it's going to show anyway?
Huh?
Why should I come if it's going to show on my face anyway?
Come anyhow. Okay? Leave the drama in the street. Before you even get there, leave it in the street. You know what? I'm going to put all that behind and just come in. Okay? Auntie wants to see us.
Okay.
We didn't make it to the barbecues. Well, I made it out, but you guys couldn't make it out. To one of the barbecues, the 4th of July picnic, you know. One time it rained around that time and nobody could make it. Even though she said, come in the house, we have it here. People don't want to make it. And everybody was saying, you know, well, Natasha and Trina, you know.
Are they the reason why nobody wants to come.
No. You're not the reason. It's just the fact that, you know, every time we get together, that's the first two things to think about. And truth to be told, Trina, they talk more about Natasha, because Natasha, she's like a vigilante, a ninja. She's ready to pull off, start cutting. You know, and I know you know, you'll get your Glock, whatever, and start going crazy, you know, being that I used to be, you know, work for correctional. You know, so I don't want you to go crazy on her. This is family, okay? This is a time to come together. This is family, not family feud, okay?
I love that show.
I know, I love it also, but this is family.
Okay.
So listen, I want you to come, okay? It's going to be December 25th. On Christmas Day, I'm going to email you. I would find out if it's going to be either at the new house Auntie got, or it's going to be at the same place we had like 5 years ago. Okay, it's probably going to be at the new house out there. It may and it may not, because she just got there like about a couple of months ago, and so I know she's still like fixing it up. It's nice, it's brand new, but she's still getting a lot of furniture. So I'm not sure. I don't know if she want to have it this time or next time. Listen, I want to do it, and after we have this. Who knows? We may have Christmas with the Joneses. You know, not Christmas with the Joneses. We may have, you know, Easter with the Joneses. You know, we may have it like that. you know.
Well, so. Don't hold your breath. Let's get through the first one.
So listen, I want you to come out. Oh, by the way, can you make your famous chicken wings?
Really? You want me to cook too?
Okay, never mind about cooking. I'm just saying, because I like them, okay? I was going to say, make like about 100. I take like 95 for myself, get the rest of the family.
You have to get that on a different day.
Listen, but I want you to come out. All right, Natasha? I'm just going to call me your sister. All right, you kind of look alike. All right, Trina? So just come on. Don't worry about it, okay? I'll be the referee if I have to, okay? Or I'll get Cousin Tony or somebody else to do it, okay? Come out
there. You don't have to watch me. Watch her.
No, she's going to be all right. All right.
Because
I know you. No, okay. I know you. Look, she's wild and everything, but I know you. You'll just be like, you doing, you know, how now, you know, I ain't saying nothing. And then all of a sudden, if she, you know, too much of her mouth come at you, you'll start to snuffing. Like that. And just walk away. And I don't want no fight between the two of you, okay? I want us to come together in love. Because you got to realize something. Sometimes family can be all you got. You know. I mean, you have God first in your life. You know, we all do. But then you're supposed to have your family. Okay? Your family's supposed to be there. If your family's not there, you know, you'll always get blessed. God will always bring you somebody in your life who's a friend, a close friend, that could be a family to you. But he first starts at home. So, you know, this is the time to get together.
And all right, disciple. Okay? That's worth it.
You just show up. You know, I'm emailing you information. It starts like about, let me see. Like I said, we're going to actually start eating like around 7 o'clock.
Okay, what time is it going to end?
I don't know. 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. I don't know.
Oh, that might be when I show up.
Okay. No, don't do that, okay? All right, you can bring your son. By the way, how's he doing?
He's doing good. He's upstairs sleeping.
I don't want to wake him up.
No, you don't need to rile him up.
Yeah, because then I know he'll start crying. If I show him a toy, you don't need him up all late at night and stuff like
no,
that.
No, it's already late enough. Matter of fact, didn't you say you had a...
Yeah, I'm going to go. Yeah, I'm going to go. I just want to finish. I was so, you know, wow. I mean, come on. Now I can barely, you know, that. Yeah, I mean, I get a chance to see the president quicker than I see you.
Oh, yeah, okay. In and out. Don't make me feel some kind of way.
All right, so listen. I'm going to get ready to get out of here. So listen, I'll see you at the...
They see me in a couple weeks.
The family gathering, yeah, 2 weeks, December 25th. It starts at 7 p.m. We're going to start eating, but, you know, get there early if you want to, okay? I know I'm going to be there early because I got to decorate, kind of set up. And may have to do a lot of praying because, you know, a lot of stuff won't happen. Which is nothing wrong with praying. Praying is wonderful. That's how we, you know, we went to church and grew up, okay? All right, sis. So give a brother a hug from the table if you can. All right. You know, so we'll talk, okay? Sharon, how are you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you doing, sweetheart?
I'm doing good. How's everything?
I'm doing just fine.
That's good. I don't know if you noticed or if you heard, we're trying to get the I'm trying to get the family together for Christmas for another gathering. Did your sister, which is, you know, our first auntie, told you about it?
No, she did not tell me.
Really? No. Okay, yeah. Well, you know what? You usually be the last one to find almost everything. But that's okay. Yeah, well, like I said, I'm getting everybody together for another Christmas gathering, okay?
Yes.
At the house. You know, your sister got a new house. You know that, right?
No, I didn't know that.
She had to tell you. She didn't tell you?
They don't tell me nothing.
Okay, well, yeah. She got a new house, and we're going to be celebrating at her new place. So I'm getting everybody together. But here's the problem. It's the two sisters, Natasha and her sister.
are at war with each other.
Oh my gosh. So you know what we gotta do?
What?
We have to pray for them.
Yeah. Prayer works. Because I pray for them. And I'm still praying. You know, I mean, Natasha, she talk about, you know, holding his unforgiveness. And I don't, you know, and I don't like what she did. And if I come to the reunion, to the family, you know, the gathering, I got to come with my razor blade. Because I don't really like y'all like that. You know how she is. She can get a little ghetto, you know. And she's just flipping out.
Oh, yes. And that's not good at all.
No, it's not. No, it's not. So, look, just keep her in prayer, okay?
I do just that.
Keep her in prayer.
And I am so glad to see you.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I saw you, and I'm like, okay. Hey, what's going on? I'm like, wow, okay.
Well, I'm not doing too much. You know, I'm just doing a little shopping here and there.
Yeah.
And, you know, and on my side of family, I'm trying to get it. I'm keeping together.
Mm-hmm. All right, so you coming, right?
If I'm not busy, I will surely come.
Yeah,
to
okay.
The gathering.
I know you come late.
Oh yes.
Because you got other things to do, but you do come. We haven't been together in years, and you know I'm trying to get everybody together, and I'm like, okay. When I saw you, it's like, hey. I don't know. So it's gonna start like about 7, but you know you get there a little early. You know, I would get there like 4.
I'm gonna do my best, you
okay.
know, but I will be there.
Okay, no problem, no problem, okay? No problem, all right. So yeah, I'm gonna see you, okay?
You will see me.
So I know you shopping and everything, and...
Yes, I am shopping. Can't you see my bags here?
Yeah, I see your bags. So I'm gonna let you go, okay?
Okay.
Okay, so let me get up out of here.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, I gotta get up going.
Me too.
Okay. Yeah, I just got off the I just ran into Auntie Sharon, Auntie's sister. Yeah, she's on 34th Street. Yeah, by Macy's. Yeah, so everything is going good. I got everything set up. I just, you know, picked up some things and stuff like that. I'm gonna go back in the house, then I'm gonna come back out and try to, you know, buy some more stuff for tomorrow. All right, so listen. I'll see you tomorrow, okay? All right, later. You know, Christmas is a few days from now, so
okay, yeah.
I gotta go, you know, get some. We got a big family gathering coming around. You know how crazy my family is.
True. Everybody's coming from down south, too?
Yeah, some people from down south, some people from, well, actually, just my sister coming from Virginia and everything. And I got my other sister coming from here, some people coming from Jersey, you know, the whole family coming together.
Nice, man. How's your brother doing? He's doing good.
He's doing good. He just got a new job.
Okay.
Which is a good thing. It's like, you know, he goes from job to job.
Right.
I told him, yeah, look, you got a master's degree. Okay. He said, yeah, I know, but it's hard to get a job, you know, as a social worker.
Right.
I said, I know, but you know, you
can
do something.
He's got to make it work.
Yeah, you got to try to make it work. I mean, he's working. He's not like the type of person that sit home and don't do nothing.
Right.
At least he's working. That's the good thing about it and everything.
That's good, man.
How you doing, man?
I'm good, man. You know, I'm still doing my thing. You know what I mean? I got this program I'm working on right now with the gym thing. And
how does it go?
I got like a group training that I'm doing right now. I'm trying to be certified for that. Once I get certified, and then everything comes into place, you know, now I get like group training.
Okay, cool.
Right now I'm just doing like a physical training. Personal training.
Yeah.
Like one-on-one, you know.
Cool.
So my certification for a group training. So
cool. You was telling me about that. I mean,
yeah.
I know you was talking about it before. And I figured, you ain't gonna do it.
I know you like to talk well, but then again,
when it comes to something like physical fitness,
okay, you know, you do what you're thinking.
You still work out in that park up there?
Yeah, I do the Riverside. I'm there, you know what I mean? I'm usually down in Central Park, though. Okay. Like you said, during the summertime, I was there like most of the summer.
Yeah.
But now I'm like, you know, it's getting colder now, so like, I'm,
yeah, it's cool.
I'm trying to get like a little studio going.
This is December, man. It ain't July.
Yeah, true.
I don't expect brothers to be working out like that. Yeah.
You know, we still do our thing, man.
I feel you.
The hoodie on and you're good. You know what I mean?
Y'all here with your phone and everything, like you're selling drugs.
Yeah.
Wow, man. I'm gonna mess with you, man. You're in Midtown. I know you ain't gonna do that. All right. So listen, man, I got to get out of here. Yo.
Right. What are you doing now?
I'm probably gonna go to Macy's, just go shop around.
Okay.
I got a couple bucks for me, try to take some up for the family, for the house and everything, you know.
Okay.
Stuff like that.
That's cool, man. Yeah. Say what's up to the family, man.
Yeah,
I haven't seen them. I don't catch with you. Have a Merry Christmas, you know what I mean? Like the happy holidays, and just tell your folks that's what's up, man. You know?
Cool, Kyle, that's what I'm looking to say.
Oh, good, man. Let me rock those, man. Send me one for my Christmas gift.
Nah,
that's all, you know.
I tell you what, you're a good dude. Yeah. You know what? That's a man.
Look,
we're saying never give you nothing, right, man?
Yeah.
I get that to you, all right? It's a gift, man.
Yes, sir. Thank you, man.
Because it's $25.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we'll talk to you later. All right.
She's good. She's doing good in school. I'm so proud of her.
I'm glad. It's good to hear. You still at that job?
Oh, man. She's giving me a hell of trouble.
Who? Elizabeth?
What's her name again? Yeah.
Elizabeth?
Yeah, Elizabeth. All she wanted is to get me fired. She talked bad things about me. She did all kinds of crazy stuff. She just don't want to see me. She always do some stuff just want to get me fired.
Look. I told you, Victoria, your best thing to do is to leave, okay? Like I told you, I left, okay? I left because, you know, either two things was gonna happen. Either I'm gonna wind up getting fired or I'm gonna wind up going to jail because I was gonna flip off on that office and that woman, okay? But I said, you know something? It ain't worth it. So I put in for application, you know, 2 weeks, thank God they hired me, okay?
Hey, you know what, Debbie? I'm going to give her what she wants. I'm really going to give her what she deserves because if she's some sort of kind of crazy, she's on drugs or something, I'm going to tell her that she's not going to do that to me.
Yeah, she is on drugs. It's weed, coke, heroin. I don't know. She on something. Okay, she on something. I mean, it's hectic. You know, she was messing around with that guy, the executive.
Yeah, that African guy?
Yeah, what's his name? Sam.
Sam,
she messing with him.
Oh, yeah, I saw them. I saw them in the lunchroom and they eating together and putting hand on each other. Oh, my God. And if somebody else do that, oh, my God, she's going to get you fired. She's going to get your butt kicked.
And let me tell you, she always talk about, listen, you get sexual harassment, you get fired for. And I mean, like, lead by example. Practice what you preach.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Of course.
And she's up there touching this dude. And I see what's happening. One day on my lunch break, I went in the lunchroom, right? And she said, David, what you doing here? At first, I was like, excuse me? And I said, I ate to her that. I was like, it was on my lunch break. She said, can't you eat somewhere else? I said, you know what? Forget about it. It ain't worth it. I'll eat in the train or I'll go in the subway or something. Let me get her. And he was there.
And she said, some drug or something?
I don't know if it's weed, crack, heroin, blue magic, all mixed together. I don't know what it is.
She needs some help.
She needs help. She needs more than help.
Yeah, she needs some help.
She needs more than help. She crazy.
Yeah.
So, I implore you, get out. Find a new job, okay? If it's not in law yet, you know that's going to come. You haven't filed a law for a law job, right? Yeah, well,
that's where I study. I want to be a lawyer.
Yeah, exactly. You went to school for that. But until that comes, do whatever you got to do. Hey, look, I'm going to tell you right now. I mean, it sounds funny, but you better go to McDonald's. It ain't working. I'm serious. It ain't worth the stress, that woman. That's pure Satanism.
She's
that's the devil. I'm serious. She just ain't got the horn. It's crazy. crazy. I'm serious. All right, listen, where you going?
Oh, I just want to get a cup of coffee.
Okay, well, I'm waiting for the bus. The express is going by. Oh. So I'm waiting for the local bus, and it's taking forever. I think I'm going to take this train. I'm out here doing a little bit of Christmas shopping, you know what I'm saying?
Merry Christmas.
Get something. Yeah, Merry Christmas as well. Try to get the family together, eh? Yeah. My two sisters still at it. You know those two, right?
Yeah.
They still at it, but, you know, hopefully, you know.
You got it right.
Yeah, they're definitely. So listen, Victoria, I'm going to let you go, okay? Listen, you still
have
to send some hugs. Come on now. You still have to send email address, right?
Yeah, I still have that.
All right, so listen, take a look. I'll probably be here holiday, maybe like next year or something like that.
Okay.
Or you can catch up, get together, and have coffee or something like that. Okay. Okay, I definitely will. All right, you take care. Okay.
David, how you?
I'm good, man. Damn, it's everybody, man. I just saw your sister, man, Victoria, the one you used to work with me.
How's she doing?
She's doing all right, man. In fact, she kind of ran into me. Yeah, I was at the bus stop trying to take the bus to go somewhere. I was, you know, I'm doing some, you know, last minute Christmas shopping and got some stuff and everything. And she's like, David? I said, oh, what's going on? We started talking and everything. What you out here for, man?
Living life.
Living life.
She don't really keep in touch with me, but, you know.
Who? Not another girl, man. Come on,
you
man.
You know,
Victor, come on.
We've been playing so long.
Brother, you get older now, man. What you like, 40?
Now, why you gotta call my business?
Nah, I'm gonna ask you like that. But yo, man, I haven't seen you in a minute, man. What's going on? How's your brother, man?
Everybody's good, you know what I'm saying? Man. Like, you know, everybody's still living, thank God.
I hear you. Same here. How's your two sons?
They good, like, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of hard taking care of them sometimes.
Yeah, but you're a good father. You're a good father. I see how you struggle for your kids.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I see, was it Larry and Mamar, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. You're a good guy. Not like three?
Yeah. Like 3 and a half.
Well, Larry was the youngest.
Yeah.
So Larry's like about three.
Three and a half.
Mamar was four.
Yeah, Lamar.
Okay, he's the one that went with the bachelor's degree.
Yeah,
you always got a ball in this hand. Yeah, I hear you. Just like how you was, but you used to do football back in the days.
Yeah,
man. Well, I'm out here, man, doing some last minute Christmas shopping for the family, you know.
Oh, wow.
Christmas in a few days.
What so you I got?
I can't tell you. I got
you
some
got
stuff.
Some food in here. Yeah.
This dude. Yeah, you can tell now the food is in here, bro. But yo, you look good though,
thank
man.
You,
dressing up, looking like a good fella.
Yeah.
From the Black Mafia or
something. Always.
Yo, Victor, it's good to see you, man.
Always,
right.
Man.
Good, man. Look, we gotta catch up, man. You still have to say email address, right?
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah, alright, man. Alright, man. Look, you be good, man.
Yeah, you too, right, man.
Don't make no more babies you can't handle, bro.
Yeah, stay out of trouble.
Stay out of trouble, bro. That's what I'm talking about. Alright, man.
Alright, take care, my G.
Yeah. Hey, what's going on, cuz? How you doing, Natasha? How is everything? Oh, that's good. Good to hear. Well, you know, I'm just calling to let everybody know I'm on my way. What you mean you're not going? Natasha, listen. We talked already about this, okay? I spoke to your sister about this already, okay? I talked to her about it, okay? And she's willing to forgive you. Tasha, you're not going to do this. Come on now. Today is Christmas. It's Christmas Day, okay?
aunt and auntie and uncle's waiting for us. What do you mean you don't want to go now? You know, this is not right. We're supposed to be a family. You and I talked about this on 34th Street not too long ago. Tasha, listen. Listen, Natasha. No, no, listen. Tasha, you know this is not right. Okay? You know this is not right, Natasha. You know this ain't right. Okay? I have spoken to you about this over and over. Okay? Forgive your sister for what she have done. The past was the past. Let it go. I even spoke to your sister about it, okay? And even though she confessed she did wrong and stuff, she's willing just to forgive, okay? Now, don't get me wrong. She was a little kind of skeptical coming also. But I had to kind of talk out of it. She's pretty much easy. You're the hard one. Tasha, listen. Auntie and uncle prepared all that food for us, okay? I'm all dressed up and bundled, got my scarf and my jacket on, my sweater, ready to walk out of the door. And now you're going to tell me you ain't coming at all? Forget about the past. Tasha, come on now. How you going to be a church-going woman, okay, talking about you love God, and you don't have no forgiveness towards your sister who you see all the time? I mean, didn't the Bible say that? How can you say you love me whom you have never seen? Okay, and hate your brother and your sister who you see all the time. Yeah, I know you know the word. Tasha, listen. Listen, Tasha. Listen, listen. Tasha. Natasha, come on now. This, don't do this. So you really made it your mind you're not going to come at all. You know, auntie and uncle ain't gonna be too proud about this. You know that. You know they're not gonna be too happy about this. You know, it's gonna break their heart. Sending them a telegram is not, like, it's not good enough. They wanna see you in person, okay? We don't send family telegram when it comes to the holiday. We all get together. That's what a family's supposed to do. You know, Tasha, you always been a hard one. You always have been the hard one, Tasha. Okay, fine. You know something? No matter what, Natasha, we still love you. And I'm going to say this. When we have the next one come around, the next holiday, we're going to have the next family gathering come around because, you know, I'm going to try to get everybody together like almost every holiday. Okay, and even without holiday, we just get together and just talk. You know, try to bring the family together, because that's what family's about, coming together and loving each other. Okay? We're not going to have this no more. This is the last straw, okay? I mean, after you and I talked and communicated, are you going to pull this off? All right, Natasha, fine, okay? Fine. I'll call your sister and let her know you ain't even coming. And I'll let Auntie know also, okay? All right. Hey, what's going on? Listen, Natasha's not coming, your sis. Yeah, she's not coming. I tried to talk her into it, she's not coming. What do you mean you're not coming either? What's going on with us? We're supposed to be a family. This is the time of loving. Oh. So your sister says she's not coming because she had or against you. Now you're not coming. Okay? Well, I don't understand. What's going on? And I'm the only one going to be there? Come on now. This is Christmas. This don't make no sense. It's the holiday. Your sister said the same thing. You know what? I can't tell you what. I'm going to tell her. I'm scared. I'm going to tell you like I told her. All right, this is going to be the last time we're going to do this, okay? The next time we have another family gathering, probably be like next Christmas or the Thanksgiving, one of the, whatever, okay? Next time we have family gathering, okay, we're not going to go through this no more, okay? We're not going to, if I have to go pull you by your weave, by your hair, you're coming to the family reunion, the family gathering, okay? This is not right. Auntie and uncle are going to be very, very disappointed, okay? Auntie got that new place she wanted all of us to come over to, and I told her about it, and now it's like, you know, the two of y'all don't even want to come. You know, what's that? I mean, Uncle Tony already called me earlier and told me he can't make it, okay? This cousin said, well, he got stuck in traffic, he's somewhere, he can't make it. This other one said, well, I can't do it. I was expecting at least the two of y'all to come with me, at least, so we could piece this thing out. But now it's like, honey, nobody going to be there. This is not going to happen no more. This is not the way a family's supposed to be. I'm serious, okay? Well, listen. You have yourself a Merry Christmas. I love you, okay? Tell your husband I love him, the kids, okay? I'll bring your gift over, you know, perhaps after I leave from auntie, or I'll bring it the next day or something like that, okay? I will talk. All right, bye-bye. Hello, Auntie. How you doing? Happy holidays to you, too. Listen, Auntie, I got some pretty bad news. The two ain't coming. Tasha and the sis ain't coming. Matter of fact, hardly nobody from the family is coming. Yes, I'm sorry, Auntie. I just spoke with Tasha, and I just spoke to the sister, to sis. And they said they ain't coming. Tasha, she's still upset over her sister, and now I spoke to her sister, and her sister's still upset, you know, or whatever. So, I'm sorry to break it to you, but I guess I seem like I'm going to be the only one going to be there. Yes, Auntie, I know you prepared all that food. I'm so sorry. But hey, I can eat. I'm hungry. I'll eat. You know me. We'll get that together. We know we're chow down, Uncle. You know me. Uncle love to eat. Yes, Auntie, I'm very disappointed as well, and I'm very sad. I did all I can do. Cousin Tony called out, okay? The other cousins called out, okay? The other uncle said, Thomas, he got, stuck in traffic somewhere deep in Long Island, something like that. You know, he got stuck in traffic. He said he can't make it. And I'm like, you gonna get stuck all day on Christmas? He said he's been in traffic like 3 hours. And I'm like, really? So that's just an excuse I was saying not to come. I'm sorry about that, Auntie. I'm very sorry. I tried. Lord knows I tried. I tried my best to bring everybody together. But I told them this, Auntie. I even told them about your new place. I told them, yes. Yes, I have. Well, the next time we have something, next Christmas or Thanksgiving, whatever we're gonna have, I promise you right now, it ain't gonna be like this no more. Okay, this is gonna be the last time. I promise you, I'm gonna make sure that definitely. Okay, this is not gonna happen again. I'm gonna make sure everybody is available. Everybody, okay. I had to go get the relatives that live in England. cousin, what's his name? Roy and them. That moved out there. I go and do what I gotta go do. But I'm sorry about that. I tried. I really did. Alright, I'll be over though, okay? Give me like about 45 minutes to an hour, okay? I gotta stop and get some gas in my car. Okay. I love you too. Okay, I'll see you soon. Yes, I do have gifts. Okay. All right. God bless. Bye-bye.